تواصل ليتوانيا المضي قدما في طريقها غير آبهة لموقف الصين منها، وهي تفضل العلاقات مع تايوان وغيرها على تلك الصينية لأسباب كثيرة ومتعددة، تبدأ من حجم التبادل الاقتصادي وسلوكيات الصين، ولا تنتهي بخلفيات حقوق الإنسان وما ترتكبه الصين من جرائم بحق أقلية الإيغور في شينجيانغ. فما هي آخر التطورات في هذا الملف؟ ما هي تحفظات فيلنيوس تجاه بكين؟ هل ترى ليتوانيا أن الانقطاع العلاقات مع الصين تأثيراً سلبياً عليها؟ ما هي الخطوات التالية؟ وأين يقف الاتحاد الأوروبي اليوم من الصين؟ معنا من ليتوانيا النائبة في البرلمان الليتواني ليما أندريكياني، وهي كذلك نائبة رئيس الجمعية البرلمانية لمجلس أوروبا. سيدة ليما، بداية أهلا بك في أخبار الآن. هل يمكن أن تضعينا في تفاصيل ما تقوم به ليتوانيا راهنا، والأزمة يعني مستمرة بين ليتوانيا والصين، ما زالت مستمرة؟
Thank you very much, first of all, for giving me this opportunity to explain the situation, or at least to give some possibly new details of what is going on. And I very much hope that your audience, they know this story. And in a very few words, already in March, our Foreign Affairs Committee of the Lithuanian Parliament, of which I am a member, agreed that Lithuania should leave 17+1 format. The format designed part of the OBOR strategy, the format designed by China for countries of Central and Eastern Europe. In May, our foreign minister, Gabrielius Landsbergis, stated that Lithuania no longer considers itself a 17+1 format member and does not participate in this initiative. The next step, or the next event China paid attention to, was information distributed, if I'm not mistaken, in August, that Lithuanian government gave its consent to the opening of the Taiwanese representative office in Lithuania. And China immediately recalled its ambassador. They also insisted that Lithuanian, our ambassador, Diana Mickevičienė, should go back to Vilnius and where she is now. So the atmosphere at the moment is that we see what's going on, we take into account, but at the same time, we are not to reconsider our decision. And in the Lithuanian parliament, we are working hard, we are amending our laws in order to have everything ready to open our economic and trade representative office in Taiwan.
سيدة ليما، يعني تنضم ليتوانيا اليوم إلى لائحة الدول أو إلى مجموعة الدول التي لديها مشكلة مع الإكراه الصيني. هل يمكن أن تخبرينا ما هي تحفظات ليتوانيا على أداء الصين أو سلوكيات الصين بشكل عام؟
I think, you know, I am not that much surprised with the current situation. Lithuania is a democracy. Lithuania, knowing the past of Lithuania and our history, I am the signatory of the Act of Restoration of Independence. For 50 years, Lithuania was occupied by the Soviet Union. So I am one of those who voted for the restoration of independence. And for us, democracy is not simply a slogan. Human rights is not a slogan. And our foreign policy, policy in general, they are those policies are value based, and we are ready to support all and work together and cooperate with all democracies around the world. Those things are extremely important to us. Speaking about People's Republic of China, they have different attitude, they have different values, and that is why, you know, this gap between us, it's visible, it's logical, and I understand that the PRC did not like our resolution adopted in the Lithuanian parliament about genocide of Uyghur people. I think we adopted that resolution in April earlier this year with a huge majority of votes in support of that resolution. So don't be surprised. It's what we have in the world now, it's democracies versus non-democracies.
هل يمكن أن نقول أن حقوق الإنسان، أو حتى أكون أكثر تحديداً، أن يعني ما يجري بحق أقلية الإيغور كان من الأسباب التي ساهمت في إذكاء المشكلة بين ليتوانيا والصين؟
Yes, we defend human rights. Human rights are extremely important to us. And not only human rights, it's democracy. It's human rights. It's the rule of law. I'm speaking with you not only as the member of the Lithuanian Parliament. I am also the vice president of the Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe, the institution which unites 47 countries of the world. So it's not about us, that it's only for us human rights are important. There are so many countries in the world who take care of human rights, who focus on human rights, who push forward human rights. When they, you know, look for their cooperation partners, for their allies, and so on.
هل هناك خوف من أن تنعكس هذه الأزمة على ليتوانيا بشكل سلبي؟ أعني التبادل الاقتصادي. هل يمكن لهذا التبادل أن تكون له انعكاسات وتداعيات سلبية على ليتوانيا؟
You know, China, the PRC, is a huge country. But would you believe that our turnover, trade turnover with China in 2020 was only 1.5 billion euros? And our export to China was something like 300 million euros. Chinese exports to Lithuania, 1.2 billion euros. So China is huge, but at the same time, from our perspective, China is small. And can you also imagine that Bill, our Lithuanian businessman, invested in China more than China invested in Lithuania? And this the amount of investments is these numbers are shocking. So when we joined, Lithuania joined 17+1, of course we had expectations. We had another government, a different government in the country, but expectations were high. And this participation in the 17+1 format, which is now 16+1, were not met. So there is, and at the same time, the region, Japan, Singapore, South Korea, this region of the world is extremely important to us. And we would like to extend our presence there. We would like to develop our cooperations with the countries of the region. And then Taiwan comes as a very logical partner. And as I said earlier, we already made our decision. We are ready to talk with the PRC, but we are not to reconsider our decision to exchange economic and trade offices with Taiwan. And we are going to follow the path, the example of 18 EU member states, if possibly even more, the countries which for years have economic and trade offices in Taipei, in Taiwan, and even there are examples like for instance United States of America or United Kingdom, whose heads of a similar offices are diplomats. In our case, the Ministry of Innovations and Economy, they will appoint the head of our economic and trade representative office in Taiwan.
إذن موقف ليتوانيا من الصين بات واضحا، لكن الأهم، هل يمكن أن تخبرينا ما هي الخطوات التالية التي يمكن لليتوانيا أن تقوم بها تجاه الصين؟ بمعنى آخر، ما هو مخطط ليتوانيا الجديد أو القادم؟
Now we are expecting a business delegation which should be coming to Lithuania later this month. They are coming to Europe. They will be visiting three EU member states. Lithuania is one of them. And of course, business community in Lithuania, they're waiting for this delegation with very concrete proposals. And we would like not just to have a posh reception for Taiwanese businessmen, but very, very concrete talks about what is possible to do, if there is a, you know, common interest of developing our economic and trade relations. We are talking and expecting Taiwanese investments in Lithuania. And, you know, this cooperation is only growing. It's growing. And I hope that we will succeed.
سيدة ليما، يعني هناك تشنج بالأصل بين الاتحاد الأوروبي والصين، وهناك أيضا عقوبات فرضت من قبل الصين على شخصيات أوروبية، وأيضا كان في المقابل عقوبات من الاتحاد الأوروبي، من البرلمان الأوروبي تجاه جهات صينية. اليوم ما هو موقف الصين تحديدا؟ يعني أين يقف، عفوا، ما هو موقف الاتحاد الأوروبي من الصين تحديدا؟
I think that the European Union is something very new. And if we take into account that the comprehensive agreement on investment, which was negotiated between the PRC and European Union, if I am not mistaken, for 7 years, is frozen now. And European Parliament said very clearly, until, you know, sanctions imposed on European politicians, including members of the European Parliament, will not be removed, there is no way of having this agreement on the agenda of the European Parliament and for the ratification. You know, our strategy, I have quite a number of publications about One Belt, One Road initiative in English and in my native language, in Lithuanian. And, you know, how I see the goal, the main task of this our strategy is to cut transatlantic relations between European Union and United States of America. And point number two is to dominate in the world. During their party congress, the very last party congress of the Communist Party in China, they said very openly, they would like to dominate in the world. They are not talking about balance. They are talking about domination. And that is completely unacceptable to the European Union, countries members of the EU, and I'm sure to the United States of America. So Chinese leadership should rethink their stance, their position, and what the message they're sending to the world. We are free people, we will defend our freedom, whatever happens, and we are not going to change our position. Lithuania was occupied for 50 years by the Soviet Union. We know what it means to be occupied by the communist country, by the dictatorship, if you wish. And we will never come back to that, and we will use each and every method, alliances and so on to avoid this. So coming back maybe also to your question, the reaction of the European Union to Lithuania's position to leave 17+1, to agree that Taiwanese representative office will be opened in Lithuania. We received a lot of support from the EU, from the Vice President of the European Commission, High Representative for, you know, Common Foreign and Security Policy, Josep Borrell, and also other prominent Europeans. By the way, including also former Secretary General of NATO, Anders Fogh Rasmussen, member states from our region, from, you know, other countries of the members of the EU who are a bit far away from us. So, and the very last European Council also discussed EU-China relations. And our president, Gitanas Nausėda, spoke again that, you know, all those divisive formats created by China, they are not good at all. And that we have to focus on 27+1, 27 EU member states and China. And in the past, German Chancellor Angela Merkel, she was proposing to have a summit of this format. Now our president is, you know, proposing or repeating the same proposal and pushing it forward. That would help a lot. All 27 EU member states and China at one table, talking about our relations and about our common future.
سيدة ليما، يعني ماذا لو زادت الصين من حجم الضغوطات على ليتوانيا؟ ما هي الخطوات أو كيف ستتصرف ليتوانيا مع ذلك؟
Yes, we feel that, you know, there is we feel pressure from the PRC. Freight train services connecting Vilnius under China's Belt and Road Initiative were suspended. Lithuanian food exporters, they are under pressure. But look, I already mentioned this, that imagine Lithuania with less than 3 million population, our investments in China are much bigger than Chinese investments in Lithuania. So they could bully, as I also said, that big China is small here. It's small here. So it's up to the PRC leadership to think about this, why this happened really. And we feel confident that we are doing a right thing. We will not reconsider our decision. We are to open our economic and trade office in Taiwan. We are welcoming Taiwanese representative office in Lithuania. We look forward to develop our relations, economic and trade relations, not only with Taiwan, but with other countries in the region, as I already said, Singapore, South Korea, Japan, and so on. And that is our perspective. That is how we see the situation. And that is how we see our mission, the current government, how we see our mission to give a new impetus to Lithuania should be that our country should be economically growing, having new partners in different parts of the world. Not only in the closest neighborhood in our region.
سيدة ليما، يعني منذ أيام صادف اليوم الوطني لتايوان، ما هي الرسالة التي يمكن أن توجهها إلى تايوان؟
I would like to send my best wishes to Taiwan and its people and the president of the country and the parliament of the country, the government, and to say long live Republic of China. On Taiwan.
سيدة ليما أندركياني، نائبة في البرلمان الليتواني وأيضا نائبة رئيس الجمعية البرلمانية في أوروبا، شكرا جزيلا لك على هذه المقابلة.